car repairs have set us back a little.
We're back in Italy once again for another round of the Formula One World Championship. And what a great race is in store for us today, here at the oldest circuit on the calendar, which hosted its first race all the way back in 1922. With top speeds up to 215 and an average lap speed of around 155 miles per hour, Monza's reputation as one of the fastest circuits in the sport is well earned. We have 11 corners on this 3.6 mile track, with the best overtaking chance coming into the heavy braking zone of the Turn 1 chicane. It's time to take a look at our starting grid for today's race. It's Sergio Perez on pole today, and a very happy Carlos Sainz will start second. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Russell, Hamilton, Pierre Gasly, and Norris, Ocon, Verstappen, Tsunoda, and Valtteri Bottas, Stroll, Moore, Charles Leclerc, and Ricciardo, Magnussen, Joe, they've taken a grid penalty, Alex Albon, and Mick Schumacher. Latifi, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
Well, I imagine they'll be starting to feel the adrenaline as they anticipate the rundown into Turn 1, a bit like preparing to go into battle. The unknown situation will bring nerves, but that's a good thing. It will keep them focused on the moment and on their surroundings as we build towards the start of the Grand Prix.
Okay, this is our engine supplies home Grand Prix, so let's give them a race worth watching. Okay, so our system checks are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up. Well done, good finish. You stepped up and achieved what we asked. Good job.
And here's our winner pulling their Ferrari into Parc Fermé after a fantastic race. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today? Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. Affects the Drivers' Championship. More increases their championship lead. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
I have to give it to Moore. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
Let's move on to the Constructors. It was a tough race for our championship leaders, who lose ground at the top of the table. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend for them as they fight their way towards the top. After an event like that, who knows what the sport has in store for us next time out. Be sure to join us once again as we continue to bring you all the excitement of Formula One.